Hello, my name is Ivan Chang, and I have never seen an exhibition by the artist A. Arakawa. Have you? I have read about him though, and seen a scramble of video on the internet. He gets fatter or thinner, or his hair changes, or his clothes change from click to click. The different camera represents him differently. I really like the memory of seeing a video of him walking through the capital city of Georgia. Something like a little war. I think it is something like a symposium or a summit. Frozen moments. Architecture speaks back. Research and leisure. The ruins of our times. My favorite moment is later in the video when he is by a concrete balcony and groans into the microphone. Actually, let's go to the other side of the river. Actually, let's go to the other side of the river. Pokon North. What even is gesture without language? I think that Giorgio Agamben writes about the gesture as always being something, a gesture of not being able to figure something out in language. It is a gag on the proper meaning of the term, educating first of all something that could be put in your mouth to hinder speech, as well as in the sense of the actor's improvisation, meant to compensate a loss of memory or inability to speak. From this point derives not only the proximity, but also the one between philosophy and cinema. Cinema's essential silence, which has nothing to do with the presence or absence of a soundtrack, is just like the silence of philosophy, exposure of the being in language, of human being, pure gesturality. The Wittgensteinian definition of the mystic as the appearing of what cannot be said is literally a definition of the gag. And every great philosophical text is a gag exhibiting language itself. Being in language itself as a gigantic loss of memory, as an incurable speech defect. Arakawa has conductor buttons in both hands while the audience crowd labors away, moving things across this courtyard like fluttering bits of fabric. Just a courtyard, just a crowd. The crowd looks altruistic and too casual to appear on screen, but this is the idea of the dance. This is the idea of the dance, but this is the idea of the dance. Improvisation operation of a thought gesture by an artist with a performing mask. The mask is in my mouth and goes to my ear. The first time I saw him full body, he was demonstrating this dance for three girls dressed similarly. I don't know what this is called. The working titles for this performance are still working. Flat dogs, pragmatism on ice, or soft dogs, pragmatism on ice, or listening to Spooky Black, or petrol on ice, or labored futurity, or touche into shrine, a tear of petrol is in your eye, or staircases on ice, or swimming in Egypt, or poems about dogs, or the softest horse. Thank you. I want to show you a video of me with my bichon frisé. I'm in the park with my bichon frisé, and I cuddle him in my arms, and I turn to the camera to say, yes, my husband gets jealous. We are companions and best friends, just like a human. A bichon's hair never stops growing, and they must be groomed every 8 weeks. It's a rare human who can resist the charm of a bichon's frisé. Lots of humans swear their bichon smile, a human smile. But he's not always happy. The bichon hops onto his hind legs, and I say, good dancing, buddy. And feeding a treat. I love my dog. I love my dog. I love my dog. I love my dog. He is naughty sometimes, but then again, who isn't? Which actions are inscrutable? What is transparent? Can't you read his face? Can't you find the signifiers? Can't you break down the taxonomical divisions of our relationship and painted on a tea towel? What that mess? Sometimes he barks and says, grandma, and can also speak to me, I love you, I love you. Reciprocity or imitation? And who tells the truth? What am I lacking that I try to find? What am I looking for? I suppose there's also the question of why or what meaning can be asserted from abstract sounds. I suppose there's also the question of why or what meaning can be asserted from a sequence of gestures. This harness? Is it training or restraint? The view here is very nice. A. Arakawa's work has been described on some heights. If I look into the sky and I see a plane across an ice, when I still watch the television, there were these advertisements from Quetens Airlines, beautiful little children singing a song that Peter Allen wrote and then filmed in sweeping cinematic images by tourist attractions. Those kids, I was fixated on those television advertisements, which ran from I was 6 until I was 18, and I never lost my desire to be one of them. Something here about the relationship, about I feel two cities that never close down. But no matter how far or how I Australia. I'm always traveling. I love being free. And so I keep living. Sun and the sea.
Sons and daughters,
all the sons and daughters,
away from their family and
away from their family
and but as the world gets colder and I'm
Australia.